Hello and welcome to Unboxing with Bill. My name is Bill Hirschinger. I'm the Director of Engineering at Standard Electric. Today we have two special guests. Andy Schonert from our engineering group. He's been with us for quite a while now.
10 years.
10 years. Damn, it seems like about 15. But anyhow,
thanks.
Andy's our business development specialist for our enclosure products. And we have Denis Kletter. He is the channel manager for Rittal, straight down from Minneapolis.
Thank you.
What I'd like to see is what the heck do you guys have for us today?
Oh, I'm so glad you asked that. I can't wait to show you what we brought today.
Oh, another darn box. Can we stand up for this?
Yes, I think we need to.
Well, let me see. Can I open this? Let's see. Watch out.
Yep. Is there a beer in this one?
I hope so, because last time I got spoiled with you with those. I cannot do it, so I'm just going to throw it down over here. You want to pull it out? No, you can pull it. I'll hold the box. I'm going to throw that over there. All right. Do we need a knife to cut this?
We're going to need a knife to take it all apart. And yep. I'm going to explain why it's packaged the way that it is.
Okay, let's do that. I'll take my knife off the ground.
So this is our AX enclosure. I want to point out the way that it's packaged first. So traditionally, it would come in a box like you just tossed over there.
Yep.
This product is packaged differently on purpose. We only put a cap of cardboard on the top and the bottom and wrap it in shrink wrap for a reason, because it reduces the amount of product that your customer will have to recycle with the cardboard or dispose of with the heavy-duty shrink wrap on there. So let's take the banding off of it and
I'm gonna try this the rest before the knife. Usually you can cheat. Ooh, these are pretty tight. Okay, we're not gonna cheat. We're gonna cut it.
Okay, so your customer receives this. They remove this. They can just recycle these and dispose of the plastic, like I said. Let's take it out of the bottom and set that aside. And if you can go ahead and open up.
I'm going to let Andy do this.
Okay. Let me scratch the enclosure.
Yep, you can scratch it. The RAL 7035. Or what is that? What's the paint color on this?
RAL 7035.
7035 textured finish.
And these are made in Germany, is that correct?
That's correct. We do make these in Germany.
Any tariffs on these yet?
There are not. No tariffs, no price increases. So, hey, before we take that off, let's point out that we don't attach the door to the body of the enclosure itself. And we do that on purpose, because the customer will typically take the door, they'll set it aside so it doesn't get damaged, or they'll send it off to be modified. We're taking care of that for them already. The other piece of it, we don't install the back panel. Every one of our enclosures comes with a galvanized back panel.
Yep.
So we slid that along the back side of the enclosure.
It was in the bottom.
It's not gonna scratch. It's not inside, but same thought process there. So customer will take that, send it off to be modified to be able to mount products on that.
And then you also have a pack of goodies in here, it looks like. We got
all
a gasket
hardware
for the gland plate.
Yep.
That's another good feature to point out on this.
And then another bag of goodies.
That's what's all in there. The gland plate on the bottom allows the customer to do easy cable entry. So rather than modifying the entire enclosure for cable entry, they can simply remove the gland plate, do the modifications to the gland plate, and then reinstall it into there. So bench modifications, a lot easier than managing that.
Very nice.
And the whole thought process here is if you have a customer that's using multiples of these, it helps speed up their processing time.
So what's holding this? Is there an adhesive on here?
There's an adhesive back.
So, okay. There it is. Right there. Okay. On each side. So
anyway,
very nice.
It's what, are the, loose. What are the ratings for this?
So NEMA 1 all the way up to NEMA 4, including 3R12. So it has the drain hole plug here for 3R and is a good NEMA 12 and 4 solution as well. And
very
in this
nice.
In this package, there's the hole plugs and everything, so this can be sealed up to NEMA 4.
And inside you have the, what do they call these? The
ground
nuts?
That's to mount
for
the back,
for the back panel, and then your mounting feet for the areas for the mounting. right? They're the mounting hangers or whatever.
The wall mount brackets. What's nice about this too is they have these kind of protrusions here where the bracketing that's used with some of the VX enclosures can be utilized in the wall mounts as well.
Yeah, so you can install additional accessories that you might use in a wall mount or maybe even some of our other product lines into this to kind of allow it to be more useful with the accessories that are standard.
Right, then, so you don't have to mount components just on the panel. You can mount it on the side.
And the grounding stud is there. Is there one on the door at all?
There is.
There is?
Yep.
Typically one or...
Actually screws right into the...
Into the rail.
Into the rail.
So that's where it'll make contact.
And you know, to your point, Andy, the stiffeners on the door here also allow for additional equipment mounting there.
This is very nice enclosure, guys. Thank you for bringing it to our attention. Don't forget to contact our account managers for our Rittal business and make sure you engage Andy Schonert and Bill Antrim for our Illinois and Indiana business. And Denis, is there anything to add with our tariffs coming around or anything like that with pricing at all?
You know, today we don't have anything in place that has increased the price of these, either in a surcharge or a price increase. I know some of our competition has already implemented some increases based on the tariffs. This product would be a great product to convert some of those competitive products.
And can I say Saginaw and Hoffman?
Sure, go for it.
Okay, and those were kind of the ones you were hinting at?
Absolutely. Displacing Saginaw and
there
Hoffman.
There it is. You heard it from me, not Denis, not Andy. You heard it from me. Thank you, Denis. Thank you, Andy, for showing us the new AX enclosure. And don't forget to contact our account managers and get us engaged. Standard Electric's here for you. Thank you, and we'll see you in another Unboxing with Bill down the road.